Today the topic of discussion in mechanics of machine is velocity analysis. As you know, any of the machine or mechanism is made of links and joints, and most of the links they are in motion. If you want to find velocity at any point on the link, then this topic will help you a lot. Before proceeding to the formal topic, let's discuss another important concept in mechanics of machine. It's called Kirchhoff's law. So this law is valid for four link or bar mechanism. Link and bar are the same thing. So this law is valid for the four link or four bar mechanism. According to the Kirchhoff's law, the sum of the lengths of smallest and the longest links will be less than the sum of the lengths of remaining two links. So to clarify this law, let's see an example at bottom right hand side. You can see a four bar mechanism, and the length of each of the link is different from the other. So the link L1, the link 1 is has a length L1, link 2 has a length L2, link 3 has a length L3, and link 4 has a length L4. As you can see, the longest link is L1, so it's denoted by the capital L, and the smallest link will be definitely link 2. So this length is represented by capital S. So according to Kirchhoff's law, the sum of the length of smallest and longest link will be less than the sum of the remaining lengths of remaining two links. So the smallest link S, length of smallest link is S, length of the longest link is L. Is if they sum up, they will be less than the length of remaining two link. The sum of the remaining two link L3 plus L4. Or also you can write, as you know, the capital S represents the length L2, and the capital L represents the length L1. So both the equations, this one or that one, they represent the same thing. So let's back to the formal topic, velocity analysis, and we will be performing the velocity analysis by a relative velocity method. So we have to perform this velocity analysis on any of the link. So one of the simplest link is the binder link. So we call a binder link which has two nodes or two joints. Joints and links are the same thing. So here you can see on the left hand side a link which has two nodes, one node and the second node. So in order to find a velocity at any of the point, first we have to point some like notations at each point. For example, at this point we are representing this point by A, the capital A. This point or this node is represented by the capital letter B. And also, if you want to interested, if you are interested to find velocity at any other point on this link, you can easily find it, and you can make a notation like we have done it here. So we are interested to find velocity at this point also, so we are mentioning this point as capital C. So the link will have two type of motion: the angular motion or rotation and the linear motion. So the angular motion is represented by the letter omega or angular velocity. Similarly, if you want to find the velocity of point B with respect to point A, what we are doing, we will just draw a line perpendicular to the link, and it will be denoting velocity, the linear velocity B with respect to A. So this B, VBA is relative velocity of point B with respect to point A. So what we are doing to find the linear velocity or the linear relative velocity, what we are doing, we are drawing a line perpendicular to the link. So this sine represents perpendicularity. Similarly, we are also interested to find the relative velocity at point C. So we will draw a line perpendicular to the link, and we will denote this velocity, the relative velocity, as VCA. So this represents a relative velocity of point C with respect to point A. C with respect to A. C with respect to A. Similarly, the distance between a point B and C is represented by R, the capital R, and the distance between C and A is represented by the small letter R. If you recall your previous knowledge, then the relationship between the linear velocity and the angular velocity can be represented by V is equal to R omega. So V is the linear velocity, omega is the angular velocity, where R is the distance between any of the two points where you are interested to find the velocity. So in our case, we are interested to find the velocity, relationship between the linear and angular velocity at point B and point A. So what we are doing, we already know that line drawing drawn on perpendicular to the link at point B will representing the relative velocity of point B with respect to A. Similarly, if we are interested to find the relative velocity at point C, what we are doing, we are drawing a line perpendicular to the link, and the linear velocity will represent relative velocity of point C with respect to point A. So the relationship between the linear and the angular velocity will be represented at point B is VBA. This VBA, the linear velocity, is equal to the distance between the point B and A, because we are just to find the relative velocity from B to A, and also the angular velocity omega. Similarly, the relationship between the linear angular velocity at point C will be VCA, the linear velocity or relative velocity between relative velocity at point C with respect to A is equal to distance between point C and A, which is the small r, into the angular velocity. So we know the relationship between the linear velocity and the angular velocity is equal to r omega, and the linear relative velocity of point B with respect to A is equal to the capital R, which is the distance between point B and A, into the angular velocity omega. Also, the linear relative velocity of point C with respect to A is equal to the small r, which is the distance between point C and A, into the angular velocity omega. So what we are doing, we are moving all the terms except omega on the other hand side. So we will leave omega at the left hand side, and we are moving the linear relative velocity VBA and r onto the left hand side. So what will happen, omega will be equal to linear relative velocity B respect to A divided by capital R. So this equation will be 1. Similarly, for the other one, the VCA is equal to R omega. We are leaving omega on the left hand side, and we are moving the other terms on the right hand side. So what is happening on the right hand side, the linear relative velocity of point C with respect to A divided by small r. So this will be equation number 2. As you can see, in equation number 1 and equation number 2, the left hand side, they are common, both are omega. So we can equate equation 1 and equation 2 because the left hand side are the same. So what is happening here, VBA divided by R is equal to VCA divided by a small r, or we can also rewrite this equation as VBA divided by VCA is equal to capital R by small r. So that's what we have got from this analysis. Now we are moving to identify the velocity vector analysis. Let's see what happens in the next slide. To perform a complete velocity analysis, we need two type of velocity terms. One is the relative velocity and other is the absolute velocity. In case of relative velocity, we already defined the relative velocity at any point on the link with respect to another point on a link in the previous slides, just as the VBA is the relative velocity of point B with respect to point A, and whereas the VCA is the relative velocity of point C with respect to A, and both these velocity vectors are perpendicular to the links at the respective points, for example B and C. So these relative velocity terms are with respect to some point on the same link, such as VBA is the relative velocity at point B with respect to A, and VCA is relative velocity at point C with respect to A. So both the velocities, these two, the relative velocities are with respect to same point, some point on a same link. As you can see, point A, point C, and point B, they are on the same link. But as you know, that the combination of links form a mechanism, and almost most of the links, they are in motion. So it's fine that we know the motion of one point with respect to another point of the same link, but also we have to know the motion of one point with respect to whole mechanism. So in this case, we need a frame of reference. So in case of frame of reference, it's defined for the whole mechanism, not for the one or two or three links, but for the whole mechanism. As from the beginning of this lecture, you have noticed that four link mechanism. So in case of four link mechanism, there are four links. So if they are in motion between that these links are in motion, so for sure, yeah, we can find a relative motion of at each link with respect to some point on the same link. But if we have to find a velocity or motion with respect to whole mechanism, what we are doing, we have to define the term absolute velocities. So if we want to find the absolute velocity at point A and point B with respect to whole mechanism, then we have to define a frame of reference. In case of frame of reference, we have a vector, velocity vector of point A, just as in the green color you can see the VA, whereas the velocity vector at point B is a red color, VB. So the velocity vector, the absolute velocity vector, will have some magnitude and some direction. Similarly, as in red color you can see the absolute velocity at point B will have some magnitude and direction and represented by VB. Similarly, we can have a absolute velocity at any point on the link with respect to whole mechanism. So with respect to whole mechanism means we have a absolute velocities at any point on the link with respect to some frame of reference, and this frame of reference will be for whole mechanism. So I will repeat again, in case of relative velocities, what is happening, the relative velocities are with respect to some point on the same link. For example, relative velocity of VBA is the relative velocity of point B with respect to A, and VCA is the relative velocity of point C with respect to A, and all these points are B, C, A on the same link, whereas the absolute velocity VA and VB, they are defined with respect to frame of reference, and frame of reference is defined for the whole mechanism. So we have two terms, in terms of velocity. Number one is the relative velocity, and the second term is absolute velocities. So we need both the terms for the formal vector analysis of the velocities. So in next slides we will form a velocity triangle by help of these velocity vectors, the velocity vectors of relative velocities, these two, and the absolute velocity, these two. So here we are doing a complete velocity analysis. The two things that are known to us from the previous slide is the relative velocity terms and the absolute velocity terms. So the top left hand side figure represents the relative velocity terms, which has VBA represents the relative velocity of point B with respect to A, and VCA, which represents relative velocity of point C with respect to A, and the both velocities are perpendicular to the points on the links. So as you can see, VBA is perpendicular at point B on the link, and VCA is perpendicular at point C on the link. The other terms are the absolute terms, which is absolute velocity at point B, which is a red color vector and represented by VB, and the absolute velocity at point C, which is in green color, VA. So what we are doing, we are taking all these velocity vectors with respect to point O. So what we are, first we will do, we will move a line parallel to the VA, the green color, and of the same magnitude, and we will move this line at point O. So here's our line, the green color VA vector. Similarly, the other vector is the absolute vector, absolute velocity vector at point B, which is VB, the red color. So we are drawing this line a parallel to this vector and of the same magnitude. So we are moving this to here. So the green color line was moved from here to here. So direction and the magnitude is same. The red color is moved from here to here, and the direction and the magnitude is same. Similarly, you can see we have drawn a vector from point here, the small a, to small b, which represents the same vector we already known to us, the relative velocity of point B with respect to A, which is here. So what we are doing, we are moving this vector from this position to here. So actually what we have right now, we have a triangle of three vectors. Vector VA, the green color, which is the same thing as this because it has same direction and same magnitude. The second vector is VB, the red color, which is from move from here to here. It has the same magnitude and same direction. The third one is the vector VBA, which is move from here to here, from here to here. So this represents a relative velocity of point B with respect to point A. So please, at this point, don't confuse the capital AB with the small AB. The capital A and the small a, they are different things. The capital B and small b, they are the different things. Just this point is represented by small a. You can take another letter like x, y, z as you, or maybe l, m, n, o, whatever you want. Similarly, this point, this small b, can be taken as any other alphabet of your choice. So but a vector from this point to this point represents VBA, which is a relative velocity of B with respect to A. So it's the same vector here to here. The very last thing that left is from this figure is this vector, VCA, which is a relative velocity of C, point C with respect to A. So if we draw a vector of same magnitude and the same direction, if we move this vector from here to here, so we have partially completed the triangle, the velocity triangle. The only thing is left that if we have to find a velocity of VC, how we can find it? Because we know that we can draw a absolute velocity from here to some direction, but we don't know the magnitude. But from this vector, the VCA, now we can configure our velocity vector VC. So how we can do that? Just drawing a line from point O to the end of VCA. So this velocity vector starts from here, ends at here, and it has the same magnitude as of this vector and the same direction. So what we are doing, we are drawing this, and by drawing this we know now the direction and the magnitude of velocity vector VC, which is in the blue color. So here we have completed our velocity analysis, and this velocity analysis is by relative velocity method. In case you have some question or queries, then please let me know. I know this topic is a bit difficult to understand, but if you pay little attention to it, then the things become simple. Bye.